This video was sponsored by Skillshare. In our previous discussion and theory of the Owl House, we touched upon how, thanks to Lilith betraying the Emperor's Coven in order to aid her sister, there is now an open spot for leader of the Emperor's Coven. A spot that I believe will be filled by none other than Amity Blight's mother, Odalia Blight. However, this week, I want to explore the other side of things. While the Blights could be on a come-up, what about the Clawthorns? What would be Lilith's new purpose in life? And sooner or later, won't Ida have to adapt and let go of her current job as well? And if so, where could they end up? Well, I think various episodes throughout Season 1, including the season finale, have perfectly set up Ida and Lilith's new occupation. One that, in my opinion, would validate the strong presence of Hexside throughout Season 1. As a critique I saw lied in the fact that, despite the Owl House's setup of Ida being Luz's mentor, we've had more than enough instances of Luz getting a handle on magic through courses at edgy Hogwarts. And although I really enjoy the Hexside setting, despite its presence likely being an influence from Disney itself, gotta cram in a high school setting, I think Season 2 could help everything land in a really cool way. So let's talk about that. But before we dive in, we have a word from our sponsor. This video is brought to you by Skillshare. A huge help for keeping oneself occupied during these times, Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people. You can explore new skills, improve at your passions, and get lost in creativity. Skillshare offers a large variety of classes, ranging from art to film to game design to video editing to even music, designed for real life and all the circumstances that come with it. Of course, you probably want to learn more about art and animation. When it comes to animation, I don't think most outsiders know how crucial character design is, or what it even is. Character design is way more than just coming up with how a character looks in concept art. In fact, when it comes to the actual job title at a studio, you're actually designing characters and poses based off storyboards, not creating designs and passing it off to the storyboarders. Still, you'll want that design experience to get to that point. Which is why I recommend Character Design Crash Course, Dynamic Design in 4 Steps, by Melissa Lee. Within an hour and some change, new artists will have a better handle on the ins and outs of designing an appealing yet simple character. Skillshare is curated specifically for learning, meaning there are no ads, and they are always launching new premium classes, so you can stay focused and follow wherever your creativity takes you. The first 1,000 people to click the link in my description will get a free trial of Skillshare Premium. Creativity is self-care, and during this time in the world, we definitely need some productive escapism in a community that's nothing but learning. The things you care to learn. It's also ridiculously affordable. It's less than $10 a month with an annual subscription. Get started at skl.sh/theroundtable1020. Again, skl.sh/theroundtable1020. Once more from the top, Lilith's assistance in Luz and Ida's attempt at a jailbreak likely means immediate termination from the Emperor's Coven. Not only that, but because she now shares half of Ida's curse, her magic has now been weakened, as confirmed by Lilith herself at the end of Young Blood, Old Souls. And due to Ida using up all of her magic and her sack of bile in Agony of a Witch, the sack itself is pretty much useless, as confirmed by Dana in her Reddit AMA, leading to Season 1's conclusion of Ida picking up glyph magic, something I initially believed to be a role reversal of the series, Luz now being the one to teach Ida. But if you've seen my video on why Luz needs a talisman, you know why I believe Ida will excel at glyph magic, likely surpassing Luz in what I imagine to be a very short amount of time. But not only that, Ida's livelihood is in jeopardy. Although she was publicly pardoned by Bellos, Ida and Luz sacrificed one of their most valuable assets, the portal to and from Earth, the human realm, which isn't only a gateway Luz needs in order to return home, but as established and seen early in the series, Ida needs this method of transportation in order to keep her business afloat. Her entire operation is selling what was once human belongings. And even if she maintains a level of inventory now, eventually, the stock is going to run dry. So with Ida and Lilith both heading towards unemployment, what the hell is going to be their next move? Well, this is where I believe plot lines will collide. Ida and Lilith are both regarded as immensely powerful witches. Their proficiency in magic is nothing to sneeze at. So if anything, instead of sitting around twiddling their thumbs, I believe the Clawthorn sisters will put their skills and knowledge to good use, meeting with Principal Bump, and not only becoming teachers at Hexside, but by extension, forming a brand new coven. I imagine Bump already has the utmost respect for Lilith, and although he still tends to be annoyed by Ida in present day, they're far from on bad terms. As while enrolling Luce in Hexside, Bump ensured that Ida atoned for her student record, and he was even down with Ida chaperoning Grom, something he probably regarded as a sign of responsibility and growth from Idalyn. Not to mention, it's worth going back and taking a look at why Bump allowed Luce to enroll in Hexside in the first place. Bump regarding Luce's presence at Hexside as a good thing for the students, that they could all learn from a foreign exchange student. And that's a sentiment that I believe could evolve if Ida and Lilith were hired onto Hexside staff as teachers. Because after all, even if Bump wanted to hire them, what would they teach? I'm sure teachers for all the tracks would be filled up, right? Well, that's where Ida and Lilith comes in, offering to create a brand new track. What would this track be? None other than Glyph Magic. Because once Ida picks it up and adapts to it, I'm sure she'd be able to actually teach it. If Lilith's magic has been weakened, I'm sure she would want to pick it up too. And if anything, if Bump doesn't trust Ida to teach a class on her own, I'm sure he'd be way more comfortable pairing her up with her sister. And I do think this is something that Bump would go for. Considering the first day saw Bump bend the rules and allow Luce, Gerbo, Barkus, and Viney enroll in multiple tracks. Now that we've had an entire season, it feels like Bump is actually a bit of a sweetheart, and I do believe he would see the value in the students picking up on Glyph Magic. Ida herself is the case for such a track to be implemented. After all, if the great Ida Clawthorn, the Owl Lady herself, is able to find herself incredibly weakened to the point where her sack of bile no longer functions, then really, what witch is safe? The education of Glyph Magic can be argued as a necessity, a backup plan that any witch needs. And naturally, I think that would lead to a Glyph Coven. Mainly because I think that would be a great out for Lilith and potentially Ida. You have to join a coven. The show already hammered that in time and time again. And although her fate could already be sealed due to the events of the season finale, I doubt Lilith would want to be a wanted woman. She doesn't want a bounty on her head. And now that she's out of the Emperor's Coven, she is covenless. But if they're able to get a Glyph Coven formed, then suddenly, she can be in the clear. Hell, maybe Ida could be a solo teacher at Hexside, while Lilith becomes the leader of the Glyph Coven. Or maybe even vice versa. Maybe they'll throw a curveball and form an actual Bad Girls Coven. The idea of Ida leading a Glyph Coven fascinates me. As we know, she originally aspired to join the Emperor's Coven, but obviously, that didn't work out. Ida forming a new coven? That just sounds too good to pass up. And it could be something she actually goes for. Although Bellus is keeping his eye on the inhabitants of the Owl House, I wouldn't be surprised if he actually approved of Glyph Magic, as he would likely see it as a valuable asset for the Day of Unity and believe he could quickly seize control. But as always, these are just my thoughts and I want to hear yours. What do you think? Do you believe Ida and Lilith could teach Glyph Magic at Hexside? Do you believe one of them would lead a Glyph Magic Coven? Or do you think something else entirely could happen? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below or tweet your thoughts at RoundtableVids. And for more of my own thoughts, you can find me at AustricFox. We're also on Instagram. Special thanks to Janky Bones for creating an awesome thumbnail. For more of their amazing art, you can find them on Tumblr at Janky Bones, Twitter and Instagram at Bone Janky, and subscribe to their YouTube channel. Link in the description. Help Druntable grow by either becoming a member of this channel or supporting us over at Patreon. Link in the description. If you enjoyed this video, please sort of like and subscribe to the Roundtable for more great cartoon content. Thank you for watching, and I hope you have an awesome day. Ostrich Fox, signing out.